Good evening, gang. Today is Sunday, February 13th, 2022. I appreciate you all joining me, especially because the Super Bowl is probably starting pretty soon. By the time I do this video, get all the editing done, it's probably going to be gone. USGS listed a magnitude 4.2 earthquake 55 kilometers south of White City, New Mexico. Very deceiving because these earthquakes are occurring in Texas. White City is about 34 miles from this location, and the earthquake is near the border. Right there is the 4.2, not far from an earthquake they had in September, a 4.2 that was on September 8th of last year, 2021. Let me bring this out and show you. Let me close this, and you'll see the border. Right up there. That's the border. This is New Mexico. This is Texas. This area is just ripe with wastewater disposal. A lot of people refer it to fracking. I often refer it to fracking. But these earthquakes are man-made. You can see all the platforms here. And this is really dumb. Maybe they didn't care. I don't know. Let me bring it out. I'm going to show you something. This here, in the same location, cutting right through where all these earthquakes are happening, is the Rio Grande Rift. A rift is an area where the United States is trying to pull apart. Yeah, it's a stretching. This area of the Rio Grande Rift is actually wider than what it is going up towards Colorado. It extends farther than what I got drawn out. This is also an example of where the United States is being torn apart. Every year, this rift system moves the distance of about the width of a penny. I'm going to go back down here to this 4.2. Because of this rift system, it has created a lot of faults. You might be interested over here by El Paso. Let me bring it out. There is the Franklin Fault. Hold on. Okay, there's the Franklin Mountain Fault. This area is capable of having a magnitude 6 to a magnitude 7 earthquake, and many subdivisions were built right on top of the fault zone, which was caused by the Rio Grande Rift. And I've talked about how earthquakes in one location can create earthquakes that are connected in other locations. And here's an example. The rift goes right through Alabama Street and probably extends farther through all these neighborhoods. I'll give you a link to this paper. The wastewater disposal definitely increases the threat of a large earthquake. In 1882 in West Fort Collins, there was an earthquake. It was one of the side branches, a magnitude 6.6. Here it says, we have neither a good seismic network or a long historic record, written records in the region extending back only 150 to 300 years at the longest. And those would be records coming from New Mexico. But the earthquake reoccurrence interval on major faults is at least 500 years. Also, Colorado, Wyoming, New Mexico region has had the poorest seismic instrument coverage than any other earthquake-prone region in the western United States. For example, prior to the year 2000, there were only two or fewer permanent seismographs in the entire state of Colorado. Here it says there is geological evidence that multiple major earthquakes of magnitude 7.0 to 7.5 magnitude have occurred in Colorado and New Mexico within the last 15,000 years. So here's a map. They got it divided up into three different sections. Let me bring this down for you so you can see it. Up here we got Denver off to the east. The Rio Grande Rift was named after the Rio Grande River. The river formed like I've talked about before. Fault zones often have rivers and streams. They love to follow those fault zones. And then down here, let me bring it down a little bit farther. We got New Mexico, Colorado, and then down here through Texas. So here we have a satellite view of all the recent earthquakes. Like I said, there's been 12 so far today. Some of them 5 kilometers in depth, which is about 3 miles. 2.8, which is 7.7 kilometers in depth. So that would be about 4.7 miles. This one was 6.2. That was a 2.8. 3.0, 2 3.0s, or 3.5 before the 4.2. We got a 3.6 and a 2.9. That's all today. That's a 3.5. Normally, they have what's called a stoplight. When they have an earthquake of a certain magnitude, they stop the injection of the wastewater disposal that is creating these earthquakes. You can see these platforms, and they're really close to where these earthquakes are occurring. In fact, a little more than 2 miles. Might be even closer. You know, depending on where the wastewater disposal wells are at. I'm just looking along here. This road that's close to the earthquakes and where these facilities are at. This is a really sparse populated area. But did any of the workers feel these earthquakes? I don't know. They might not even say anything. If so, put those comments down below of what you felt. I'm sure they went out and inspected the different pipes. You can see we got, probably pipes down through here. Yeah, how long is it going to take them to go out and do an inspection? So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for any kind of disaster. It could be a tornado, it could be a snowstorm, earthquakes. You just don't know. But you should have some sort of emergency supplies, a bug out kit in case you have to relocate because of something that could have happened. Thank you very much for watching. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.